Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So it's been a while since I did a food and a recipe specific video. So for today, I decided to share with you guys three simple ways in which you can use your leftover rice by making them into really simple and absolutely delicious pulao recipes. So in this video, we're going to start off by making a mixed veg pulao. Next, we're going to make a palak pulao. And third, we're going to make a red chili pulao with a little bit of Chinese twist to it. So let's start with the first recipe, which is the mixed veg pulao. So I'm starting off by taking a little bit of ghee in a pan. Once the ghee all melts up, I'm going to add some cumin seeds to this, some cloves, a star anise, and a little bit of jawitri. You can also add black pepper pods, which I have added, but if you don't like it to be very spicy, then you can completely skip that. Give all this a good stir, and once all the masalas kind of come together, we're going to add onions to this. I have not chopped onions very finely. I have made them into little julians, but you can do it as per your liking. So once the onions are completely done and they become nice and golden, I am now going to add a lot of mixed vegetables. Now these mixed vegetables can be anything that you like. I have added peas, carrots and beans, but you can add mushrooms, paneer or anything that you like. Give all of this a good So after the vegetables are all nice and done, for some extra seasoning, I'm going to add some pulao masala. The one that I'm using is by Shan Masalas, but you can use anything by Everest, MDH or anything that you like. And then just give all of this a good stir and get all the vegetables to kind of come together. So once all the masalas are nicely coated with the pulao masala, I'm now going to add my leftover rice to this. And then I'm just going to mix this rice up really well with all of the vegetables so that the rice also gets nicely coated with the masala and the vegetables. You can definitely make this recipe with fresh rice, but in case you're making this with leftover rice, ensure that all the lumps from the rice are gone. So yeah, that's it. The simple recipe is all done, and this is how beautiful it looks. Trust me, it's absolutely delicious. This makes up for a really nice lunch recipe, a nice dinner recipe, or you can even carry it in your lunch boxes. So, moving on to the next recipe in this video, we are now going to make a really tasty and a very healthy palak pulao. So for that, we're going to start off by blanching our spinach leaves. So first thing you do is take some spinach leaves in a pot and add the required amount of water to it so that all the spinach leaves are nicely soaked in the water, and blanch this for about 5 to 10 minutes. After it's all nice and done, drain the water and add the spinach leaves to a grinder jar, and then grind it up really well by adding a little bit of water. Adding water here is optional. You can choose to not add it either. Just make it into a really nice palak paste that looks absolutely beautiful with that green color. Once this is all done, in a pan I'm going to take about a tablespoon of ghee. You can use oil as well, but I prefer to make this with ghee. I'm going to add some dry spices, so I'm adding jeera and long here and some black pepper pods. I also add a little bit of jawitri for flavor, but this is completely optional. And then I'm going to add just a little bit of garlic paste. After this mixture turns nice and golden, I'm going to add some badam to this to make it a little bit more healthy and also add a little bit of crunch to the whole recipe. So I'm going to saute all of this together really well, and once it becomes nice and golden, like the whole thing comes together really well and cooks off, I'm going to add some coriander leaves to this. Now this step is really important because this is what adds a blast of flavor to the whole pulao recipe. So add the coriander leaves and then add the palak puree. Once the puree mixes up really well with the rest of the masala, for seasoning, add a little bit of salt, some red chili powder, very little, just for the namesake, add a little bit of turmeric powder and some coriander powder. Give all of this a good stir and then bring it to a little bit of a boil. After the whole thing comes to a good boil, add your leftover rice to this, or you can add freshly made rice, that's completely your choice. If you're using leftover rice again, make sure that you get all the lumps out. And that's it. This is a really, really simple recipe. The beautiful looking green colored palak pulao is ready to be served. You can use this for lunch, dinner, or it's a perfect recipe for a lunchbox. So you can totally use it as a lunchbox recipe one of these days in the week as well. Now, the last recipe in this video is my personal favorite one. If you're somebody who likes spicy food, this particular recipe is just perfectly made for you. So what we're going to make here is a chili spring onion rice, and we're going to add a little bit of Chinese twist to this. To start with, in a pan I have taken very little oil, and to that I've added 1 tablespoon of garlic paste. Once the garlic paste cooks really well and turns golden, I'm going to add the top part of the spring onion, the onion part of the spring onion. I have used about 3 spring onions here, and I have used just the top part of it. So add that to the garlic paste and then give it a good mix. And next you add the middle part of the spring onion, which is the greenish white colored part. That's what you add, and you give all of this a good mix. Let all of this cook on a really high flame. And then we're going to add very little low sodium soy sauce. This is optional, but the Chinese twist in this recipe actually makes the flavor come out really well. So I'm going to do that. And another optional ingredient that I'm adding here is chili flavored oil. So I know this is a difficult product to find, but if you actually find it anywhere close to your house, make sure that you actually add this to this recipe. But even if you don't find it, the recipe is going to be just as good, so you don't have to worry about it. Next, I'm going to add the paste of 2 dried red chilies. So I soaked 2 dry red chilies, and then I made a paste out of it after soaking it for like 15 to 20 minutes. And to balance out the spiciness of this, I'm also going to add a little bit of tomato ketchup to this recipe. So bring all of these sauces together to a nice mix. Cook all of this on a really high flame, and then add your rice. So again, you can use leftover rice or fresh rice, that's completely your choice. Mix the rice together with the rest of the sauces, and then in the end top it with the leaves, the green part of the spring onion. And this green part, make sure that you add it only in the end, because it's nice when the green part actually has a little bit of crunch to it. If you add it in the beginning, the crunch will kind of go away. And that's it. This recipe is really quick. It gets made in like 5 minutes. It's absolutely delicious, very spicy, very tasty. And it's perfect for somebody who likes that Chinese flavor in their food. So again, a wonderful, wonderful choice for a lunchbox recipe, for lunch, dinner, anything that you like. So that's it for today's video, guys. I hope you found this useful. I tried to share some very simple ideas in which you can use your leftover rice. It feels bad when you have to waste food. So there are simple ways in which you can ensure that the food doesn't actually go to waste. Let me know how you like this video in the comment section. And if you're new here, ensure that you subscribe to my channel. We're so close to 10,000 subscribers, and I'm really excited for this. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.